Hi, this is Raphael Mudge, the creator of Cobalt Strike. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate session passing from Cobalt Strike to Core Impact. So I'm going to show you how to spawn a Core Impact Windows agent from Cobalt Strike's beacon. Here we are in Windows 10 with the Cobalt Strike GUI client installed and Core Impact. Having both on the same system is very helpful. Our Cobalt Strike team server, though, is in Amazon's EC2. All right, let's do some session passing. Let's go over to Core Impact, go to Modules to get the module browser, and let's search for Package and Register Agent. Double-click the module, and we are going to configure this to export an Windows agent, 64-bit. We will save that agent file onto the desktop somewhere. So let's just go up a few folders. And let's drill down into users, user, desktop. And let's change file type. I'm just going to save it as agent.bin. That's all. Okay. Now that we've got Windows 64-bit agent.bin, change binary type to raw. This will export the impact agent as position independent code, and that's very important. Click agent connection, and I like to use connect from target, which is reverse TCP. It's a reverse TCP connection. It is the most performant channel, so that's a good one to use. We'll do port 9090, and I think we're good to go. Let's go ahead and hit OK. And package and register agent is running, and we can see it is now waiting for a connection on port 9090, and our agent file is saved. Perfect. Now let's go over to Cobalt Strike, and I'm going to just unmaximize this, make it a little smaller, make it so we can see our beacon console interact, and we're going to use a command called shspawn, which is shellcode spawn. This is the Cobalt Strike command to run a temporary process and inject position independent code into it and run it. And so we're going to do shspawn x64, and we'll just press enter to get a file browser so we can choose agent.bin. One thing I do want to note, Cobalt Strike by default, when it does process injection, uses read, write, execute memory. You can turn this off in your malleable C2 profile, but if you're going to pass sessions to Core Impact, don't. The Core Impact agent needs RWX memory to bootstrap itself for the time being. And so if you're using Cobalt Strike, do not skip on the RWX memory. You will need it to session pass. And if you're not getting an agent back, it could be your profile, because RWX may have been turned off. It is on by default. All right, so let's grab agent.bin. And when our agent checks in, grabs it, and?
New agent deployed.
New agent deployed. Great, we now have an agent in Core Impact, and we can now start doing things from Core Impact, which is a lot of fun. So that is an example of passing a session from Cobalt Strike to Core Impact. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. Good luck and happy hacking.